had that feeling, the gas gauge headed towards empty. The mileage you expect to get from your car is a big deal. Gas is a significant expense, and we want to be sure that the mileage estimates that come with our cars are accurate. Ryan Pisulkowski, you put these figures to the test here at Consumer Reports. How'd you do that?
We actually splice a super accurate fuel meter into the fuel system of this vehicle. That allows us to measure exactly how much fuel is getting burned in this engine. It's sending an electrical pulse up this wire, and we run this wire into the cab where we have a readout, and the readout is showing us how much fuel is being used. What do you say we go for a ride?
Oh, I'd love to.
I'm gonna take you to the city course where we do city fuel economy testing. This course mimics a city driving cycle. So there's stop and go, different speeds.
Oh, like if there were like lights at each corner.
Exactly. We're trying to mimic a real world situation, but on our closed track. The stop and go traffic, some traffic in front of you kind of speeds up, speeds down. But we do the same speed every time we go around this course. We're checking. We're making sure that that readout that's showing us how much fuel the engine's using.
So how do you use that information?
We can convert that number to a mile per gallon number. And there are times when we actually see a different number. And we had a few manufacturers had to change numbers because we weren't getting what they were promising.
MPG is a simple calculation. You take the amount of miles driven divided by the amount of fuel consumed. The stickers you see on many cars actually have two fuel economy estimates. One is for city, as we just saw, and the other is for highway driving, which is where we're headed next.
So the track is big. I mean, we have 327 acres. We have all kinds of straightaways and tracks and stuff, but it's not big enough to do steady state 65 mile per hour highway fuel economy testing. For that, we actually come out on a real highway and measure the amount of fuel we use in a certain distance at 65 miles per hour steady state.
So now this machine will probably read different numbers than the city ones.
Exactly, because on the highway, a vehicle's actually more fuel efficient because now we're in a higher gear. When you stop and you take off, the motor has to rev up. You're using more energy. So once we're going, we have this momentum on the highway that it's actually more fuel efficient.
Okay, so what can you do to improve your car's fuel consumption? First, Ryan says you'll burn more fuel by going faster. So if you reduce your speed from 65 to 55, you could add an astonishing 7 miles per gallon on a mid-size car. Avoid bursts of acceleration and braking. And make sure your tires are properly inflated by checking the sticker on the door jamb or the owner's manual.
So if I'm gonna go buy a car, what are the things that I should be looking for?
On the window sticker, there'll be the EPA number. You can decide for yourself if that's something you can afford to drive, and if that's the impact you wanna make on the earth. To have this big SUV is sometimes nice because you can move all the stuff, but if you're not gonna use it to its fullest, you're just wasting fuel.
And there's some advice to fill your tank with.